Okay, so the next question is, why do you believe in the existence of God? And so I want to give 10 minutes to you to share your personal reasons, because I'm involved in a lot of Christian atheist debates, and a lot of times, like William Lane Craig, for example, he might say in an atheist or Christian atheist debate, I'll bring up these arguments, but that's not really the reason why I believe. I personally believe because I have a field relationship with Jesus and all that, but in a debate, I have to give logical reasons, and so I give these reasons. So the question here is like, let's make it personal. Why would you believe in God? Because I used to believe in God and I don't believe in God. So what is your problem, Phil?
What is my problem?
Why do you still under this God delusion?
We need to make a distinction between two kinds of reasons, and you need to tell me which one I need to give you.
No, for you personally,
yeah,
why?
Yeah, I'm not. They're both personal. They're very both personal.
Okay, anything.
One is occurrent and one is dispositional. The difference between occurrent and dispositional things.
Just the biggest reason.
Let me explain so you can ask.
Okay.
I am said to love my wife. I really do love my wife.
Mm-hmm.
Do I feel love for my wife at all times? In fact, right now when we're arguing, do I feel love for my wife? When I'm asleep, do I feel love for my wife? No. It is not occurrent.
You don't remember until you wake up.
Well, some of my dreams I do. So an occurrent belief is what I'm believing or thinking right now. Mm-hmm. A dispositional, in this case,
would you
emotional,
say current belief?
Occurrent.
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 Okay.
It's occurring.
Okay.
A dispositional belief is something that I am disposed to believe. And you have a dispositional belief that I can name in just a moment, and I will bring it up, and it will turn out that you do believe it. And that belief is Australia exists.
Mm-hmm.
See, now you believe it, whereas before you weren't even thinking about it.
I understand. Okay.
Okay. Okay. So do you want my dispositional reasons for why I believe in God or my occurrent reasons why
Whatever
I believe
is
in
the
God?
Most powerful to you personally. Like if I said, stop being a Christian, and you're going to say like, oh, I can't because I got such huge reasons for being a Christian. This is the top of my list.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Because God makes sense of the pattern of life. I've been reading.
I find that very curious because that's the reason why I left the faith is because I think that an atheistic worldview makes more sense of the world than a theistic belief.
Okay. I'm making sense of the pattern of life. So you have to ask, what are the clues in the pattern of life that it makes sense of?
Yeah, so how could life possibly make sense?
Well, I would point to several different things, and the belief in God making sense of different things gains strength from each one of them.
Okay, so like what's one, for example?
All right, the one that you mentioned before, belief in moral realism. How is it possible for people to have sincere moral beliefs and be wrong?
Okay, how is it possible for people to have sincere moral beliefs and be wrong?
Right, all I'm doing is I'm expressing moral realism in a backwards way. When something is real, you can be wrong about it. So, sincere Nazis believed that it was their moral duty before God and Hitler, actually before Hitler, to kill Jews.
Well, I believe there is a Nazi.
They were wrong.
I believe there is a Nazi morality. I have my morality, and I think my morality is superior to Nazi morality.
So we should call yours true and theirs false.
Of course. You call your morality true, you would call my morality false.
Uh-huh. Well, no, I don't know that at all. I don't know what your moral beliefs are.
Well, we're going to have some differences of opinions, and you're going to say yours is true and mine are false.
All right.
And there's another Christian over here, you're going to say he's got false morality and you got true morality.
We're just getting clear about what the realist believes. The realist says there are moral truths and people can be wrong about them.
Let me give you real quickly my idea of morality. Okay, I have a thought experiment or a way to explain this. It's just like a map. So for example, I could say, how do I get to this studio from my house?
Mm-hmm.
I can go on Google Maps and it'll show a path there.
Mm-hmm.
I think morality is the same way. You want to get to an end goal, which is community flourishing, and there's a path there.
Mm-hmm.
Now that path may be blocked by an accident or something. There's an alternate path.
Mm-hmm.
So that would be the better alternate path, giving all the situations.
Mm-hmm.
And so I think morality is the same thing. We have a goal we want to hit, community flourishing. And so what's the best way to get there?
What if people don't have the goal of community flourishing?
What other goal could there be for morality?
The goal would be the Aryan race should survive and all others be destroyed. That's
so,
one.
So they're talking about the flourishing of the Aryan race,
And others should be destroyed.
Right. So again, it's flourishing, and I would argue why I think it's better to have flourishing as a community than flourishing as the Aryan race. So at that point, we're asking the very fundamental question, what is morality all about?
That's exactly right.
Right.
The moral realist says there is moral truth, and we can disagree about it, and we can be wrong. See, the great thing about it is you would admit, I'm sure.
Do you think there's a truth about what the best path here is to a moral ideal
truth? Very often in the details there isn't. Very often. Should I have worn this shirt or vest? Yeah. It has a nice black color. I could have worn my green one. There are all kinds of things I wear. They're morally indifferent, right?
It has nothing to do with morals, right? Because the color of your vest
right.
has nothing.
And the right way to get across town is morally indifferent. But the right way to treat your neighbor is not morally indifferent.
Right, because that's all about community flourishing.
Okay.
So we're back
to the basic point. There is a moral truth, and you can be wrong about it.
There is a moral truth.
Right. So somebody comes up and says, look, forget more community flourishing. There are people who just say, look, ethics is about getting what I want out of life. Hedonism. Hedonism is the moral truth. And this is Ayn Rand.
Right.
You have a duty to be selfish.
Right.
So, you who are looking out for your neighbor, you are being immoral,
right.
She says.
Yeah. So at that point, I wouldn't have a discussion about who has correct morals. I would have a discussion about what is morality? What does it mean to you? Let's define what morality is, because we have different definitions of what morality is all about.
So you keep resisting the idea that a person can be wrong about morality. Now, the interesting thing is, most people
they're wrong according to my morality.
Well, sure. And of course,
let me give you an example. Let's say me and you are the kings, or let's say a whole community comes up with a certain morality, Nazi morality, for example.
Uh-huh.
If there's a Nazi morality, that's the morality. And if you do something wrong, you're immoral in that Nazi morality.
So now you've moved from moral realism to moral relativism. It really depends on the culture that you're in or whoever gets to make the rules.
Of course. You make your own morality rules. Another Christian makes their own morality rules. And you just end up saying, well, yours are from God and his aren't. And he says the same thing
about you. So I'm just laying out the options here. Now, notice that you asked me why I believe in God. And I was going to give you several different reasons that cohere around the pattern that coheres around the existence of God. We're not going to make it. But on this first one, what are the options when it comes on the question, how is it possible to be sincere and be wrong? Most philosophers, naturalists and supernaturalists as well, are moral realists. They will say there is moral truth, and some people are right about it, and some people are wrong about it. And if I am, it would be a joke for the naturalist to say, and by God, if I'm wrong, I want somebody to put me right. Help me out. Okay, so the moral realist says there is moral truth, and we want to find it. The moral relativist says there isn't moral truth.
Well, let me ask you a real simple question about that, just as an illustration. Is it wrong to lie?
I think it's wrong to lie most of the time. Most people do. It really is wrong to lie most of the time.
Okay, so is that subjective then?
Since
it's most of the time, it's not all the time.
No, it's not all the time. Does a moral truth have to be a universal rule with no exceptions? That's Immanuel Kant. I don't believe that.
So you're saying the morality is subjective?
No, I'm not at all.
It depends on the situation.
That doesn't mean it make it subjective.
Okay, so you don't think subjective means it depends on the situation?
No, it doesn't. Subjective means it varies from person to person.
I understand what you're saying because I've heard William Lane Craig actually explain this do you agree with me that a lot of Christian people who talk about morality have that wrong idea that... We only have 50 seconds.
Yeah,
we
didn't even get past number one. In fact, we didn't get number one done.
Yeah, I mean, I heard William Lane Craig talk about it briefly. It's kind of the same thing you're saying, where the morality depends on the situation, and yet whatever that is, that's an objective.
Yes, I mean,
So it's kind of like a subjective-objective thing.
All you have to do is be a soft universalist of any sort. Modesty is a virtue. How do you practice modesty in Saudi Arabia or in Santa Monica? Be very different in each. But modesty is still a virtue in both places.
Okay, so we're out of time on this one. So I guess to summarize your viewpoint, though, morality is one area of why you believe in God.
Right. God makes helps make sense of morality, as well as three or four other things I wanted to talk about.
Okay, interesting. Okay, so we'll go on to the next one here.